الدنيا يلا تفضيل هنا صور يا بيه رفل تصور في الزاوية.
يلا يلا
این موضوع طبیعتاً ارتباطی با حق مشروع و قانونی و شناخته شده جمهوری اسلامی ایران در پاسخ به متجاوز و تنبیه متجاوز ارتباط در واقع مستقیمی پیدا نمی کنه. به دنبال تشدید تنش در منطقه نیستیم. از تلاش های توأم با حسن نیت برای برقراری آتش بس حمایت می کنیم. در این حال بر حق ذاتی جمهوری اسلامی ایران در استیفای حقوق خود و تنبیه متجاوز و ایجاد بازدارندگی در مقابل یک رژیم تروریستی تأکید داریم و این رو در زمان مقتضی از آن استفاده خواهیم کرد. توف در زمین دولت آمریکا و در زمین رژیم غاصب صهیونیستی است. دولت آمریکا است که باید نشان بدهد که آیا هدف از برقراری این مذاکرات یک مانور سیاسی با هدف دستاوردهای سیاسی برای دولت آمریکا و خرید زمان برای رژیم غاصب صهیونیستی جهت ادامه کشتار ملت فلسطین هست، یا واقعا به دنبال ایجاد شرایطی برای برقراری یک آتش بس هست.
Good afternoon, everyone. In a very constructive meeting with Prime Minister Netanyahu today, he confirmed to me that Israel accepts the bridging proposal, that he supports it. It's now incumbent on Hamas to do the same. And then the parties, with the help of the mediators, the United States, Egypt, and Qatar, have to come together and complete the process of reaching clear understandings about how they'll implement the commitments. From here, I'm going on to Egypt and Qatar. And these are our two critical partners in this effort to get the ceasefire agreement over the finish line, to get the hostages home, to put everyone on a better path to lasting peace and security. And so I look forward to consulting with President Sisi, with the Emir, Sheikh Tamim, with other critical colleagues in both countries, on the immediate steps ahead, and in particular, what needs to be done to ensure that Hamas comes along. And the bridging proposal was to try to close some gaps or to clarify different parts of this agreement that needed clarification. Now, what the challenge is, besides Hamas agreeing to the bridging proposal, is to make sure that there are clear understandings on how the different parties are going to make good on their commitments. I should have mentioned as well, Prime Minister Netanyahu committed to sending his senior expert team back to either Doha or to Egypt to try to complete this process. For example, about polio, because we very much share the concern about the possibility of its reemergence, and we've been working on a detailed plan to make sure that those who need to be vaccinated against it can get vaccinated, and we're working with the Israeli government on that, and I believe that we'll be able to move forward with a plan to do that in the coming weeks. It is urgent, it is vital.